today I have prepared a series of 6 anime openings.
Oh.
And okay. Between the two of you, you need to be able to guess the premise of the anime just from watching the opening.
Okay, this is better. Two brains.
So, how much anime have you watched?
Like, by looking at me, you wouldn't imagine, but I've watched a good amount. Probably say like 20 full series. These are not openings that I'm already aware of.
You may be aware of a couple of them.
Okay.
I have never watched any anime, unless you count Akira, A Silent Voice, a couple of Studio Ghiblis, that's it. Ghibli. Sorry.
I've watched 4 shows, but I haven't finished any of them. Actually, no, I finished The Promised Neverland, but then they made a second season.
But it was terrible.
No one counts anime.
At Japanese Animation.
I've seen Batman Ninja and Attack on Titan and Star Wars Visions, I suppose.
I've watched like 2 shows.
Yeah, I watched the first 2 episodes of Attack on Titan.
Oh, I watched the first episode.
I've seen an episode of Naruto, because one time at a sleepover, I was the second person to wake up. My first friend who woke up just decided to make himself breakfast in my house and put on Naruto. I just woke up and accepted that.
No, I have not watched anime at all.
All right, that makes this entertaining, then.
Oh, boy.
Start with number 1.
Okay.
Do we start with number 1?
Yep, start with number 1.
This is very organized.
I know, that's why we should do it unorganized.
Just ruin everything.
I missed it.
You think you're really gonna-
You're speaking!
Wait, you really think you're gonna understand Japanese?
Alright, this one's old.
Is that a Goomba? No, seriously. It's a boy band.
There's a lot going on in this too.
What is that? That's not a... What? Who are these guys?
Real life? The last shot.
That's how it ends. I couldn't clean anything from that.
Don't really know what the plot is at all. I got nothing from that. And the girl put on a mustache and then it just confused me. And then like the guy was crying and then it looked like a K-pop band. I don't know what it means.
Dude, it's so chaotic, it's so brilliant. I can't even put together what this is. They could be explorers, but they could also be comedians.
Yeah,
no.
Did you really think
the words were gonna help? We can't even understand them. It's a whole different language. Did you think you were gonna understand?
It's a boy band. One of them can earthbend.
Not a boy band.
You're lying.
I'm not lying. You can look every single one of these up after.
No, it's not.
Oh, it's a dojo.
A dojo where they.
It was in
boy band.
Shang-Chi in the 10th thing, that temple. And it's like, I don't know what it's called.
This exact temple.
The person with black hair, long black hair, he is part of a team and they play instruments and they also dance. And he has friends and they have to compete with them. He was karate chopping the bamboo. There might be some fighting aspect. Maybe it's like a dojo or something. Probably one of the classes.
Like a band of, not like a literal band, like a group of, or maybe a literal band, I don't know. It looks like it's about like a group of characters who are just going on these adventures. It looked like Buddha's in the background for some reason.
I don't know. Is this a Goomba?
I have no idea.
To be honest,
I've never seen this one either.
So wait, what's that? What's the plot?
So this is an obscure show from the 90s called Sexy Commando Gaiden, Sugoi yo Masaru-san.
That's the whole title?
That's the whole title.
One more time!
Sexy Sexy Commando Gaiden Sugoi Masaru-san.
All I remember is sexy.
Okay, good.
I thought you heard the second half.
Here's how
sexy.
Here's the plot. This guy shows up at this high school and, like, the karate club is failing.
Oh, okay.
So he takes over the karate club and turns it into the club of the art of the sexy commando. And so the art of the sexy commando is defeating opponents by distracting them so much that they can't fight anymore.
Oh, that's... it does a good job of portraying that, then.
Like, you're so sexy that they're like, oh my god, and then they're so distracted.
Essentially. They usually distract people by unzipping their pants.
What with their pants?
They unzip their pants.
Pants.
Also, the principal's a part of the club for some reason.
What?
Is that legal?
So, like, it's like these adults hanging out with these, like, kids, like, alright, distract them by taking off clothes.
It's the Moon Knight intro.
Moon Knight smiles.
I know this one.
This is a good show.
I don't know anything about the series.
Dojo vibe. That's an awkward one. This is a classroom, never mind.
It's been a while since I heard the first one. It feels so low energy in comparison. Like when they're on the beach and they're going like that, like vibing throughout the whole thing.
Wait, they're that age? No, it's gotta be ranked for something.
It's a military school.
Well, that was a cool show. This is a lot of, okay, a supernatural character.
Is that the teacher?
That's some great choreography.
He's hitting himself.
Why is the octopus spinning so aggressively?
There's so many like words on this.
This was definitely a manga before I came, right?
Yeah.
I've seen these books everywhere.
So he's the teacher. It just said something teacher.
Okay. I mean, it was funny.
Squid Games!
Assassination Classroom. So it's a school about assassination. Like, they learn how to become assassins. There's the... he has a weird, like, the creepy face, smile, and he's on an octopus. He's the teacher that teaches them how to assassin. Do they have to kill each other?
Not each other.
Other classes?
None of their classes.
That'd be dope as
f***. Looks like they have like this supernatural ninja-esque giant yellow octopus teacher who is helping them become better, and then there's like a really dark aspect to the show that's not shown in the trailer.
Yes.
Like little flashes of blood and
Yes. These students were not originally assassins. This thing may be controlling them. It has the like wherewithal to do that. I think like by it kind of like surrounding them and like them all kind of doing the same movements. It wasn't necessarily what they came here for. I mean, I did think it was a dojo at first, but I think it's a classroom. It's a show about a giant monster assassin kind of controlling a bunch of students and making them into what it wants.
So I'm guessing the plot of the show, you know, aliens took over. Natural assumption, the aliens took over. They're like, all right, kids, we're gonna teach you how to kill people.
I don't know what the plot is. I'm assuming that it's kind of like Danganronpa, where like it's an ensemble of kids that are gifted in one way or another. Is it like a free-for-all, like a battle royale of like who is the best? Are they all trained assassins, and that's why it's called like assassin? I don't know.
Well, didn't we already get it?
You're missing a crucial plot.
What does that say? S A A U S O.
I think the crucial plot point we're missing is who they have to kill.
Is it the teacher? Do they have to try and kill the teacher?
Obviously, it's called Assassination Classroom. This octopus creature blows up half the moon.
Okay.
And shows up in Japan and says, I'm going to blow up the rest of the world in a year, but I'll do it right now unless you let me teach the kids of this, like, classroom. Now, Class 3E is basically like the F students at this middle school, the ones that gets like shunned off.
Really?
The Japanese government with their hands tied is like, alright, let's just teach the kids how to assassinate the teacher.
So I got it.
No, but I'm saying this guy comes to Earth, has them in a position where he can do anything, and his like main goal is to teach a classroom.
Does it do a good job of explaining what it is? Because it kind of just looks like kids dancing with a weird little creature. Because in the show, he's friendly. And in the intro, he's also friendly. But they don't really display that he's, like, technically the villain.
That sounds very interesting, actually.
It's really, really good, actually. It's really, like, heartwarming.
Aw, so cute. They're killing people.
I thought that said haiku, but I... Oh.
Whoa.
My favorite symbol. I'm wearing it underneath this. Oh! It's the floating heads from Rick and Morty. Yes, it was. Show me what you got. This is one of the better intro songs. Okay.
Oh.
There's blood there. Those people have to eat.
Third eye. I'm feeling the guy with the robot eye is the
bad. Oh my god, of course it's some busty chick in there.
If you're in Loathing in Las Vegas, what the f is. Wait, what?
Okay, what's the reference?
That thing is terrifying.
It's op.
It's
op. It's
op, but it looks like a cow. It's definitely an animal theme. It's... Yeah, it's definitely a cow. It's a flying cow.
Gotta say, I'm not interested. Chick with the giant tits. She's definitely like the strongest character in the show or something.
I think someone's kid got exiled and he became a bad guy.
Wait, what is that? That's a...
That's the kid who got exiled and that was bad.
There's another one with a baby. This.
The baby?
Because remember they were... That's the same... That's the same ground as when the guy was getting exiled and she was holding the baby and he was either the one kneeling or in the chair. I can't. What?
I can't stop thinking about the baby.
The baby?
Stop.
This one's gonna be like a whole wild assumption and I'm definitely gonna be very wrong. I'm guessing that these people, they live in the sky or like on really tall mountains. They've lost a ton of people. So like there was probably like a huge genocide on Earth that made them want to move to the sky where they are safe.
This dojo-esque world of supernatural fighters, kind of like a Mortal Kombat type thing, with this heavy connection between mystical arts and like these animal companions that help them along the way.
I get the sense from one of the overhead shots that this is like a town or like a city. I've never seen Dragon Ball, but I would assume this is the kind of show that it would be. Just a bunch of really powerful characters that fight each other for one reason or another. I think the one that was riding the cow is the main character.
It's called Haku Hoshin Engi. There are two races in this world. There's humans, and then there's the Senin, who kind of live in their own world. But then there's one sorceress named Daki, who is the big boobs lady.
I like how you already know who she is.
She's infiltrated the human world in like the Yin Dynasty. So then this dude sends his apprentice Taikobo and his flying hippo Supushan to Earth.
That
together.
Was the hippo!
Yeah.
Oh, yes. It is a hippo. I can see that, yeah.
And then they fight. I'm gonna be completely honest. The opening's the best part of the show. The show's not very good.
I think the plot sounds interesting, but I don't know. It doesn't look that great in my opinion.
I watched all 23 episodes. Not exactly sure what happened,
really?
But I can confirm that someone's child did get exiled at one point.
Okay.
We were both right.
So yeah. Which character were you talking about when you were saying this child got exiled?
Yeah, there's the baby. And then hold up, shut up! That's the baby.
Oh, Dr. Slump? What's this one?
Dr. Slump, bro. He has a PhD in everything.
Oh my god, headed to Dr. Slump.
Okay, Dr. Slump. Oh no.
Woo!
bank.
This is great.
Cartoon Network shows such as like Tom and Jerry, Looney Tunes. Please tell me this isn't like hentai.
It's not hentai.
I did not pick up a plot out of that. I can just see that they're very cute characters. It's not like an actual plot that goes on. It's probably like one of those shows where it's like everyday life, but like I'm quirky and relatable main character, so something always happens to me.
It's about a little girl who's got a magic friend who's like a half bug, half kid, I don't know. And they also have a friend who's like a witch, but he's like a clumsy witch.
It seemed like maybe American town, because I saw an American thing, and then I got some of the like flute and like band aesthetics. I'm sure it's just like a fun little show.
Strawberry Shortcake vibes. Definitely geared towards children. It looks like it might be educational, the way she was interacting with the screen at the end, like Dora. I feel like I'm gonna finish this and Garrett's gonna tell me this is the darkest show.
Yeah, I know, I'm waiting for it to be like, so this, this show's about a bunch of evil beings that Dora are killing kids.
Is it, they deliver kids to people?
What?
Like the storks.
I'm not with her on this.
There's a doctor who makes babies and hands them out to people in the
sky. No, the doctor helps animals.
Kate is closer, but not by much.
Why? How is she going? She was a doctor.
No, I said doctor with babies. Makes.
So it's Dr. Slump and Errol Chan. They're in cahoots.
But the doctor makes something. The doctor makes Errol Chan.
There you go.
Thing, friends?
What?
Wait, he makes her?
Yeah, that's the friends. This doctor named Senbei Norimaki creates what Wikipedia calls the greatest little girl robot. Her name is Arale, and she's the girl in the, like, who's at the end and stuff.
Right.
And basically, she goes around causing hijinks. This is actually the series that made the creator of Dragon Ball famous.
Oh.
Before he made Dragon Ball, he made this.
I can actually see that in the animation style. That one looks cute. I like it. I wouldn't watch it, but...
I've watched this one. Because of you! You fiend! We're getting his history. We're getting a little bit of history about what is going on here.
There are pirates in this show, right?
Yeah.
Is it like a... Like, I know this show. And I know that the main kid is like a... monkey.
Uh-huh.
I know this song. Oh, I see this kid.
The guy's face is creepy.
I know a lot of people like this show. But I don't know what it's about.
I guess.
Look at all of those cool things!
Dude, it's so massive and pixelated in the screen.
This is kind of giving me like Pokemon vibes. Like, I can definitely see this intro fitting the Pokemon theme very well for some reason.
Oh, he's powerful. That guy's weird. That guy likes eggs on his face.
Hey, yo!
Oh, he can stretch his arms. He can stretch his limbs.
Something so adorable about his face.
So it's just like a fun little pirate ensemble show, right? kind of.
I feel like he's the main person. Oh, there's subtitles this whole time.
We are on the cruise. Wait, have there been words the whole time?
They were in Japanese for most of the time, but for all the English words that the singer says,
okay,
they were in
English. Okay, that makes more sense. That makes me feel a little better. It looks like the pirates were trying to, like, invade a land and then got kicked out and they had to go back on their ships. You know, there's scary stuff in that ocean. They've got some huge fish that don't even look real. They must have trained well because that creepy face guy could easily punch the huge eel. He was fine, and then it looked like an FBI agent showed up and started breakdancing. I'm assuming that they're just, you know, casual pirate hijinks.
This show, I already kind of know a little bit about it. The main character, I forget his name for some reason, he leads a band of adventurers. They're sailing the seas. I think they're either collecting or they're fighting the sea serpent spirit people, and there's that guy that's like, I don't know what he did exactly. He may have, like, enchanted the sea serpents to be bad, and they're trying to, like, go, you know, fix, because the world is, like, going to shit now. My favorite character is the freaking bone dude. I don't remember his name, but I love the bone dude.
Brooke.
I love him.
I don't know much about One Piece, so I'm gonna take a wild guess and say that the One Piece is a group. Like, they are the One Piece, or they're in search for something called the One Piece.
It's a pirate ship. This kid is either a stowaway and now in charge of the pirate ship, and they go on adventures and fight monsters. And they have powers.
That's it, right? He's just a stretchy pirate, and they go on adventures.
There's one key detail that you're missing.
Okay. I think it has to do with the title.
See the key missing detail we're missing?
That there's something that connects him to the plot, and that's like your missing link.
Was that his father?
No.
He's up for execution because he stole one piece of treasure. And now it's up to them
to find
in his quirky little hat to find it.
So the guy at the beginning is Gold Roger, the king of the pirates.
Okay.
And so eventually he conquers the whole world, essentially, of pirates. And he put all of the gold that he, all of his treasure that he collected in one place. And he called it the One Piece. And so right before he was executed, he said, if you want my treasure, you can go find it. I put it all in one place. And this starts the Great Pirate Era. Everyone starts looking for the One Piece.
He's like, they're like holding the gun, they're like, oh, I put everything that I own inside of a place.
14 years later, we get to the kid with a straw hat named Monkey D. Luffy. He's like, I want to go find the One Piece.
He looked like a character that would be like picked up by pirates and be like, all right, kid, you're on our team now. And he'd be like, okay, whatever you say, creepy big dude.
That's his personality, pretty much.
Oh, cool.
Who's the guy that's like the guy with the short blonde hair that was like doing a spinning thing with his legs?
Sanji.
Is he a bad guy?
No.
He's not. It's just that's just their crew.
And the FBI agent was actually his chef.
Oh.
The reason he was breakdancing was because he doesn't like fighting with his hands because his hands are for making food. So he fights with his feet. Which is ironic because then he has to put his hands on the ground. But
yeah.
Wait, you're telling me after 14 years of every pirate on Earth searching, nothing shows up?
It's been 25 years since the series started.
And they're
still going?
Going now,
yeah.
One Piece.
Damn!
It better be in a cool spot.
They're keeping the story going, they're making money off of it, why not? At some point it must be frustrating, like, just find the f***ing treasure already.
Alright, so here's the real kicker with all of these.
Okay.
All six of these are based in manga that ran in the same magazine. For
wow.
The same audience.
Wow.
So all of these have an intended audience of Japanese boys aged 12 to 18-ish.
I thought Dr. Slump was more geared towards like a age like 3 to 12 kind of situation.
Like the rest of them I can see, but like Dr. Slump just seems kind of like for, I can see the same demographic as like Dora or something. Or like SpongeBob, like a wide age range, but like people you'd never expect to be like a fan of it.
You know, they got a bad for the third one. I mean, sure. I mean, boys like titties, I guess. Assassination Classroom and One Piece definitely are the ones that could really work for any age.
I think the difference between this and traditional American is that I think they have no problem playing with different styles.
Right.
This is really cool. I think this really shows, it shows like there is really a whole other side to this that just we don't really, you know, tap into.
I got four right.
Good job.
Six.
That was cool.
That was
well,
really cool.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
I'm not gonna watch any of these. If anything, I'll probably just go back to watching stupid on YouTube.
What, you're not completely enthralled by Sexy Commando Gaiden?
Alright, you caught me. I'm going back to watch that.